Bonjour et bienvenue dans cette vidéo qui va être dédiée à la guerre électronique. C'est un sujet passionnant dans lequel il y a beaucoup d'innovation. Et aujourd'hui, on a la chance et l'honneur de pouvoir interroger un vrai expert qui s'appelle Anton. Bonjour Anton.
Bonjour Zéver.
Vous voyez qu'il a un accent qui n'est pas totalement au point, donc on va passer en anglais. Et je vous laisse suivre un petit peu cette interview avec les sous-titres. So first, Anton, who are you?
My name is Anton Kick. I work for the high technology company Saab that is based in Sweden. And we do all sorts of technologies, but my specialty within Saab is electronic warfare, or EW.
And why did you choose this specialty? Maybe you have passed in the field?
Yes, I have experience actually in the field, where I spent many years in the South African Air Force.
As a pilot?
As a pilot, as a fighter pilot actually. And in those days we actually had a war, very little known war in South Africa. And the Soviet Union at that stage fielded their best equipment, and our Air Force had to combat this equipment with our electronic warfare equipment that we had.
And which kind of plane did you fly?
I flew the fabulous French Mirage.
Ah, this is a great plane.
Fighter. Indeed. It's a lovely aircraft.
So you were flying on the Mirage. Have you flown against Soviet era systems? Did they shoot at you?
Absolutely, yes. I mean, it was a war at that stage, so they had many derivatives of systems that are even today in use. For instance, the SAM 8 ZSU-23-4.
It's still on the field, yeah.
Many others that are still in the field. So absolutely, we unfortunately lost some aircraft and assets to Soviet surface-to-air missiles, but we defeated many of them.
Okay, and what about the electronic warfare? How can the electronic warfare fight against those systems?
So electronic warfare idea is to detect the incoming threat. That is the most important part, is detection. And then you have to have a countermeasure, either maneuver the aircraft, or if you have an onboard electronic warfare system, use countermeasures to defer the missile away from the aircraft.
So which kind of countermeasures? I guess that Saab has the whole capabilities?
Saab absolutely has the full range of capabilities. There are many technologies that are trying to shoot down aircraft these days. The main one probably is radar warning technology, which you use chaff, which deters the incoming missile.
It means that it makes some other radar echoes?
Absolutely, it makes a different radar echo, and there's of course a more sophisticated system where we actually jam the incoming threat electronically.
Okay, it means that you put some electronic emissions toward the radar so that it doesn't work anymore, yeah?
Yes, that absolutely is how it works. The second technology is a missile approach warning, where typical, the well-known SAM 7 shoulder launched missile, SAM 14, there are many of them out there these days, they simply lock onto the heat signature of the aircraft.
Okay.
So by firing a flare, which is in theory hotter than the exhaust of the aircraft, the missile will follow the flare and hopefully divert from the aircraft.
And so Saab covers this whole range. It means it can detect and also jam and also emit the flares and the shafts?
All three, or all of those that you have mentioned, yes.
All those capabilities. Okay.
Correct.
And I looked at your website, there's something called the IDAS. Can you explain us what it is?
Yes, IDAS stands for Integrated Defensive Aid System, and it's deployed mainly on helicopters and transport aircraft. Some fighter aircraft also had it.
Can you give some examples?
Yes, I can certainly. There's a range of Airbus helicopters that have our system on board. For instance, the Cougar, Super Puma, Caracal, NH90, and many others
lots of them.
The world. Yes.
And for the fighters, I guess, of course, the Gripen?
Parts of our system are in the Gripen, yes. But the rest of them are, people don't really want to talk about.
Okay,
what
but probably in the US, North America, our friends. In the world.
Yeah. Okay. Of course, our friends, yes.
And so what does the IDAS do?
So the IDAS integrates radar warning, missile warning and laser warning detectors with a countermeasures dispenser and threat indications to the pilot. And it automatically dispenses the correct threat when it senses the incoming threat. Of course, also displays to the pilot what the threat is, where it is, What kind it is and how dangerous it is.
And you're talking about laser, because we have talked about the radar system and the head system, and what's the laser for?
So the laser warner, a lot of incoming missiles, or a number of them rather, have either range finders or beam riders or some different technologies that an enemy user would point the laser at the aircraft, getting either the range or showing the incoming missile where the aircraft is by means of its laser detector. And then the pilot obviously wants to know that he's under threat.
Yeah, and we've seen recently that Russian system don't work against the laser. It doesn't seem to work very well for them.
Well, yes, if you see what's on the news, yes.
Probably. And what's the relevance of electronic warfare? Because we see so many new systems, more and more efficient, more and more sophisticated. Does it still work? And will it still work in the near future?
That is an excellent question, because electronic warfare is an ever-evolving technology, because the threat is evolving. If the enemy sees that there's an electronic warfare system that can detect and counter their threat, they build a better threat. So the electronic warfare self-protection guys, like our company, have to build a new detector to be able to, so it's an ever-evolving and changing scenario at the cutting edge of technology in the world.
And Saab also has its own radar planes and electronic warfare planes?
Yes, Saab is on both sides of the spectrum. So we in Saab have radars, not only on aircraft, but very famous land radars as well.
We have it in the French army.
Yes, that is true. We also build the radar warning detectors within Saab, so it's very good to have this marriage of technologies.
And what can you expect as an evolution in the electronic warfare field in the next future?
For the threat jamming technology for missiles, there is an instrument called a DIRCM, Directed Infrared Countermeasure, that electronically jams the incoming head of the missile and deters it away from the aircraft. That is definitely the future.
It's something like a laser that points at the head of the missile?
Precisely.
So the optic doesn't work?
Yes.
Okay.
Correct.
That's right. That's the main evolution that you're going to see?
That is one evolution. The other one in radar warning technology is a digital radar warning capability, which is a relatively new field that all the world's radar warning manufacturers are moving to and is essential to cope with future radar warning threats.
Okay, and when we're talking about electronic warfare, I wonder the French Navy in the maritime patrol aircraft, and there was a guy on my left working on the electronic warfare, okay. And he was able to identify which kind of boat was using its radar thanks to it. So I guess there are some kind of libraries that you use?
Yes, there are definitely threat libraries that we use. And Saab, in fact, has a very similar aircraft called the Global Eye,
okay,
with the Airy Eye radar on board. And this technology allows you to detect a single radar and counteract it by means of whatever systems you have on board the aircraft.
So it means that you can identify which kind of boat or which kind of aircraft are on the battlefield,
exactly,
without using your own radar.
Yes.
So they don't detect you.
That is exactly what the aircraft does.
Okay, so after that you move and you make some kind of a triangulation,
yes,
to have the right position.
Yes.
And so does it work with drones also?
Yes, if the drone is emitting, we'll be able to see it, but it has to emit something for our sensors to detect it.
And your sensors can also be on drones?
Yes, our sensors can be on drones, the slightly larger drones than the very small ones that you see, but yes.
Yeah, of course. And do you have the right to tell the name of the drones equipped? Not yet.
They're drones.
The drones, okay. Anton, thank you very much.
It is my pleasure, Xavier.
Les amis, j'espère que ça vous a plu. On était aujourd'hui à Eurosatory, c'est le début de ce salon. Je vais essayer de faire quelques vidéos du coup. Là, la mise en place n'est pas totalement finie, donc autour de nous, il y a un petit peu de chantier. Désolé pour le bruit. Si vous avez des questions, n'hésitez pas. Encore une fois, j'essaierai d'y répondre. En l'occurrence, j'essaierai de les poser à Anton, qui je ferai la traduction pour vous. Et puis donc, je vous dis à très bientôt pour de nouvelles vidéos. Merci, Anton.